addressing the Security Council.
عليها أن تستمع جيدا إلى هذه المسألة فهي دولة عظمى هي التي يجب أن تكون المدافع عن القانون الدولي قبل العديد من الدول الأخرى
which should be defending the international law first and foremost and that is the superpower which should be protecting the Security Council resolutions before anyone else because of their position as a permanent member of Security Council and as a superpower they should be the one to abide by the international law, and they should not trample the international law underfoot. They should not closing their eyes to the situation on the ground. The whole world can see this provocation, and the United States should review their position on this, that this flagrant violation of international law and Security Council resolutions. Furthermore, the U.S. administration did not just ignore the status of the city and the central role it plays in peace as a whole. It decided to transfer the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem while the Palestinian people are commemorating the 17th anniversary of al-Nakba, the catastrophe. This is another decision where the U.S. administration is totally ignoring our feelings and our legitimate rights and the feelings of Muslims, and Christians and all monotheistic religions throughout the world. This is a provocation for millions of Muslims and Christians. The United States took this decision whilst completely disregarding the feelings of everyone, including the Palestinian people. The United States should have, in their capacity as a superpower, to exert pressure on Israel to put an end to their violations against the Palestinian people, to compel them to respect international law and to create the environment conducive to getting out of the political impasse and to guarantee an environment which is conducive to peace, security, prosperity, and dignity for everyone. But unfortunately, the United States decided to do the opposite. They decided to strengthen the intransigence on the part of Israel. They decided to protect Israel from international condemnation, from their accountability, from any measure which could rectify this unfair situation, unfair to the Palestinians and their right to freedom and independence. This was a the most recent decision on Jerusalem motivated the right-wing government in Israel to implement their policies and illegitimate practices, including the broad daylight murder of innocent civilians, without any fear of consequences, because Israel has always had impunity. And this fed into the Israeli aspirations of getting control over Palestinian territory, including the illegitimate annexation of East Jerusalem. Madam President, we have to recognize that the absence of accountability and protecting Israel against any kind of sanction is what allows Israel to go even further in their settlement policies and their racist policies against the Palestinian people. They have the green light, which allows them to commit ever greater crimes against innocent people, which enables them to kill a greater number of people, to imprison Palestinians, to confiscate greater stretches of land and houses, and to displace a greater number of people, and to provoke what is happening today in the occupied Palestinian territories, including Jerusalem. This kind of impunity enables Israel to continue with their illegitimate and inhuman blockade of the Gaza Strip. This has been going on for more than 10 years. This blockade witnessed three kinds of devastating years when they tried to destroy our infrastructure, which catastrophically worsened the situation of our 2 million Palestinians. Israel decided to impose collective punishment, which is a war crime. Israel deprived them of protection. This requires an urgent action to rectify the very difficult humanitarian situation. We several times called on the Council to lift the Israeli blockade against Gaza and provide the necessary assistance to alleviate the suffering of people. Unfortunately, this to date has not been done. And we are making these appeals and exhortations today. Recall Resolution 1860 and Council statements on this. We are asking for serious measures to exert pressure on the occupying power to put an end to the blockade and to open crossing points to enable for the free circulation of people and goods in line with the international humanitarian law. We also call for the support of UNRWA, which, despite the financial crisis which was imposed on it, continues implementing its mandate and providing assistance to refugees, and continues playing an important role to alleviate the suffering of people in the Gaza Strip and meet their urgent needs. Madam President, we call on the Security Council to work without delay to resolve the sensitive issue which threatens international peace and security. The Council must work, act immediately to stop the massacre committed against our people, in particular now in Gaza. The Council cannot remain silent. The Council must demand that its resolutions be respected. We call upon all countries to work on this together and individually in order to support the international law. And this should include condemning the illegitimate and brutal attitude of Israel towards the Palestinian people under occupation. We shouldn't recognize the settlement of Israel now territories, including East Jerusalem, and undertake measures in order to ensure there is accountability and justice. Further, we need to act urgently in order to save the lives of innocent civilians and prevent the deterioration of the situation and save any possibility, however minimal, to have just peace. That's why international protection needs to be extended to Palestinian people in line with international humanitarian law. 70 years after Nakba, the catastrophe, injustice and the shock, the Palestinian people continue to believe, together with others in the world, together with all of you, that the international law is the way to justice, given this is the surest way towards peace. States should translate their words into action. It's time for immediate action, serious actions, to make sure the primacy of international law and to resume efforts to put an end to Israeli occupation, have just and lasting peace, to make sure that Palestinian people can live in dignity and in peace. They can have their inalienable rights, exercise them, including the right to self-determination and to freedom in an independent Palestinian state, and have the right of return. Our people have waited for a long time. We have suffered for a long time. We can no longer wait for an end to this grave injustice. Please do not disappoint our hopes and our aspirations. I thank you, Madam President.
I thank the permanent observer of the Observer State of Palestine for his statement. And now I give the floor to the representative of Israel.
In the meantime, South African ambassador to Israel just recalled Sisa Ngombane has arrived back in the country and is expected to brief International Relations Minister Lindiwe Sisulu on the latest in the Gaza crisis. The SABC understands that Pretoria will announce further action against Israel after that briefing, due to take place tomorrow morning.